or any combination of such forms. For example, the English text of Romeo and Juliet, as separate from the various ways is presented in different editions, is an expression of the work. Manifestation, the physical embodiment of an expression of a work. For example, the 1998 Signet Classics edition of Romeo and Juliet is a manifestation. In other words, when the expression of a work takes on a physical form, as text, film, sound recording, etc., it becomes a manifestation. Item, a single exemplar of a manifestation. For example, an item is a single copy of the 1998 Signet Classics edition of Romeo and Juliet. As can be seen, the FRBR main entities represent a hierarchical movement from abstraction to specificity of a particular information resource. In a similar fashion, Bitframe is constructed of entities in a hierarchical fashion, but instead of FRBR's four levels, Bitframe defines three. Work, a resource reflecting a conceptual essence of the cataloged resource. Instance, a material embodiment of a work. Item, an actual copy, physical or electronic, of an instance. Work, a resource reflecting a conceptual essence of the cataloged resource. Instance, a material embodiment of a work. Item, an actual copy, physical or electronic, of an instance. Thus, although Bitframe only uses three main entity classes, there is still the same movement from abstraction to specificity as represented in the FRBR hierarchy. Nevertheless, the lack of conformance to the FRBR hierarchy has resulted in much discussion, and, perhaps, even some confusion about how Bitframe relates to FRBR. For instance, there appears to be some disagreement in the literature regarding the exact relationship between Bitframe and FRBR entities, especially with regard to how the Bitframe entities may represent conflations of FRBR entities. Although a number of researchers espouse a correspondence between the Bitframe work entity and the FRBR entity's work and expression, at least one researcher sees a correspondence only between Bitframe work and FRBR work. Similarly, it appears that most researchers see a correspondence between Bitframe instance and FRBR manifestation entities, while others see a correspondence between Bitframe instance and FRBR manifestation and expression. Perhaps some of the difficulty of mapping Bitframe to FRBR lies in the basic ambiguity of the meaning of the respective concepts. For instance, as is noted by Eflaw, the FRBR concept of work is an abstraction, meaning that it is hard to define its precise boundaries and that the divisions between works and between works and expressions may in fact be culturally dependent. Furthermore, as other researchers have noted, efforts at operationalizing the concept of work have led to at least two different conceptions of the concept. For instance, some have argued that a work can be conceived as the intellectual content of an endeavor with no assumptions about how it is physically realized, while, from a different point of view, a work can be conceived as the sum of all common attributes, author, title, etc., from a set of manifestations. Perhaps complicating the matter is the fact that neither Bitframe's nor FRBR's hierarchy constitutes a definable bibliographic whole. For instance, although FRBR's entities are organized hierarchically, and are often pictured within a box, there is no single concept to which this hierarchy relates. The need for a kind of super-entity has been noted well in the literature. It would seem that these questions regarding FRBR are equally applicable to Bitframe, since Bitframe does not include a super-entity that encapsulates the work and instance entities. Thus, it appears that there may still be some serious conceptual difficulties that need to be overcome if Bitframe, as an entity relation model, is to be a viable framework for bibliographic description. Nevertheless, because Bitframe appears to be a simplified version of FRBR, perhaps some of the conceptual difficulties regarding FRBR will not negatively affect Bitframe as much. For instance, perhaps Bitframe's conflation of FRBR's work and expression concepts is useful, since it is sometimes difficult to determine the boundaries between a work and its expression. However, since the Bitframe initiative has suggested that its model is agnostic, meaning that it can be applied to any model, it must be able to be mapped clearly to other models if it is to foster interoperability. Yet, as one researcher notes, to make the model completely agnostic may be unrealistic, since to be perfectly interoperable, both models require almost equivalent semantics and granularity, a situation which would suggest the redundancy of one of the models. This does not seem to be the case between FRBR and Bitframe, which means that the initiative may need to re-examine the possibilities of BibFrame working with other models. BibFrame is designed to be content standard agnostic, meaning that the model does not include requirements or specifications for the use of any particular content standard for bibliographic description. In fact, per the initiative, BibFrame is intentionally underspecified so that any content standard may be applied successfully within the context of the model, including those that have yet to be developed. Thus, this intentional underspecification is designed to maximize the extensibility of the model and to help ensure its usefulness in a wide range of extant and future information management contexts and use scenarios, as well as for the widest variety of current and future resource types. However, since the BibFrame initiative has positioned the model to be the replacement for MARC as the primary method of bibliographic description and data exchange between libraries, the initiative is doing more than simply ensuring the openness of the model to accommodate RDA and other content standards. Per the initiative, the designers are planning on taking an active look at the elements in RDA and other content standards, including the Anglo-American Cataloging Rules, 2nd edition AUCR 2. As a number of researchers have noted, it appears that BibFrame is also being designed to specifically accommodate RDA, which suggests that this particular content standard may be playing a stronger role in the design of the model than may have been suggested initially. As BibFrame is still under development, it remains to be seen exactly to what degree RDA plays a role in the design of the model and what effects this might have on the model's extensibility. Nevertheless, BibFrame designers suggest that the use of profiles will be another way to accommodate a variety of content standards within the model. A BibFrame profile is a document, or set of documents, that puts a profile, for example, local cataloging practices, into a broader context of functional requirements, domain models, guidelines on syntax and usage, and possibly data formats. According to the initiative, such profiles can be used to define constraints in the creation of BibFrame records such as those required by any content standard, including RDA. As other researchers have noted, RDA may not have gone far enough in distinguishing the content from the carrier of information resources. This potential fundamental flaw in the content standard may pose further difficulties in mapping RDA to BibFrame. Such difficulties are presented in the study which shows the uneven mapping between existing RDA classes in BibFrame 2.0, particularly the RDA expression class. The study demonstrates many-to-many relationships in the mapping between RDA and BibFrame. Nevertheless, as BibFrame is in a relatively early stage of development, the nature and magnitude of these difficulties remain to be seen. The current web environment is structured in such a way that machines, and thus users, are unable to take full advantage of the links that are established among and between resources. In other words, the web is an environment composed of web pages and hypertext links that do not describe the nature of the links that connect pages together nor the nature of the data, content, contained in web pages. In other words, as many researchers note, the current web is a web of documents versus a web of data. As a result, current search mechanisms, such as the major search engines, are limited in their ability to utilize information on the web, relying almost solely on harvesting algorithms to index the content of web pages and then to match this indexed information against the search terms entered by users. While, as one researcher notes, this method has served the web well, permitting users to locate needed resources within the vast sea of online information, it lacks the ability to lead users to related content, even when complex and intelligent relevancy algorithms are employed. Furthermore, within the context of the library community, it means that most library data remains relatively difficult to locate online and relatively static with regard to other online resources relevant to library holdings. In other words, library data, in its current form, remains in the proverbial silo of its online catalogs. However, through the employment of semantic web technologies, there is the potential to expand the uses of library data in the web environment and thereby to enhance user experience of this data.